David, you are settling down in Paris. Do you think that Paris can compete with London in terms of art market? Can it exist?
I think the honest answer is that the art market will remain larger and stronger in London for a while, primarily because the auction houses really do a lot of business there. But I feel the gallery scene is very energetic here. And I think the quality of shows and what the galleries can do can certainly rival what's happening in London.
But what special can you do in Paris that you don't do anywhere else?
Okay, so that's an easy question to answer. When we came to London, quite a few artists already had established gallery relationships that, of course, we respect. Almost none of the artists and the states we represent have those relationships in Paris. So we are very free and can show many artists that we couldn't show in London.
Okay, but is there a special orientation? I mean, Paris is known for its high level of culture, classical culture. Shall you be more classical here?
Definitely not. I think the answer there is, I think we've, over 26 years, kind of figured out what we can do and what we might be good at, and that's what I want to bring to Paris. I don't want to change the way I look at what I show and how I show it, because I'm in a new city, in a different city. I really want to bring my program and the vision of the gallery to this great city, and hopefully the audience will like it.
And what about Monet? Do you think they're seen as collectors around?
You know, that's a question I'm asked a lot, but remember, our market is now no longer a regional market. If we do a Raymond Pettibone show, I'm sure when the dust settles, we will have sold works to Paris collectors, but also to collectors in China, in Singapore, in England, you know. So while you want a vibrant regional market, so it's interesting when you have an exchange, and of course that exists here. There are incredible collections in Paris and incredible institutional collections in Paris.
But after all, if everything is global, why to open a new gallery and more expenses again?
I didn't say everything is global. What I'm saying is there's a connection between the region and the global, the regional and the global. And a gallery that knows what it does has to connect those tools, right? So we have to have a digital outreach for what we do here. But ultimately, the most important thing is that you build gallery spaces that inspire artists. And if a space inspires an artist to do a great show, you have the chance to connect on the regional level or on the global level.
But in a period of such insecurity, I mean politically, doesn't it worry you to open a new space, to have more expenses?
Fortune favors the brave.
Merci.